And then to both of you, I wrote a letter to the FTC last October highlighting potentially anti-competitive contracting practices by hospitals and insurers. The Wall Street Journal reported on a so-called anti-steering contracts that prevent insurers from steering their members to lower cost, higher quality care providers simply because the dominant hospital doesn't want to face competition. Chairman Simon, has the FTC looked into these practices in more detail since my letter last fall? Are they problematic? What actions, if any, has the FTC taken?
We're very interested in looking at unilateral conduct by hospitals that are problematic under the antitrust laws. But generally, when we do that, we find that they're nonprofits and we don't have jurisdiction over them. And so that's another reason why we've been asking the Congress to eliminate our exemption for nonprofits.
Gosh, I never gave that any thought. We ought to consider that.
Yeah, please do.
Okay. So I can address that as well, since we do. Congress has given us the authority to look into nonprofit hospitals, and perhaps another example of things you probably wouldn't start from the beginning. But we've had two enforcement actions on exactly that type of practice, the anti-steering. One involved in North Carolina, Atrium Healthcare, to which we were prepared to litigate. It had been in investigation for over 3 years, and we entered into a consent decree where the hospital system terminated those practices just this past year. And then the second one was in Michigan, a hospital system that had done that. I can also report to you that there is a working group within the administration to look at if there's a regulatory way to address these types of anti-steering provisions, and the White House has expressed a lot of interest in this issue.
Thanks, all of you, and continue to be helpful, please.